Look at the goaltenders, Mike, going at it. Here we go. Brent Johnson with deep end zone. I want to see it. Here we go.
Come on, hit him with a left. He popped. No, he hit him. He's not going to hit him again. But he's going to hold him down and don't let him up.
Well, he hammered him good.
Look at the goaltenders. And here they go. Byron Defoe gets the mask off Patrick Lalime and starts hammering. Lalime trying to get the mask off Defoe. Defoe lands a couple of rights. Oh, a big right hand by Defoe. Defoe's got Lalime down.
Patrick Lalime was never going to set the world on fire, but he did manage to have a respectable career in the NHL as a goaltender. Patrick Lalime began his career in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League, playing for the Shawinigan Cataracts, back in 1991. To say that his junior career was less than stellar would be an understatement, as his best year came in 93-94, while playing in 48 games, had a goals against average of 4.15, and a save percentage of .876. Nonetheless, he was selected 156th overall in the 6th round of the 1993 NHL Entry Draft by the Pittsburgh Penguins. There wasn't much pressure on Lalime early on, as he spent his first few seasons in the IHL and ECHL before coming up to the Penguins organization in 1996. Lalime's first NHL appearance wasn't much to write home about, as he would replace Ken Reggett midway through the game and let in 2 goals on 14 shots, on the Penguins' way to an 8-3 loss against the New York Islanders. A few weeks later, he was given another chance, again replacing Ken Reggett, and only letting in 1 goal in 17 shots on the way to a Penguins victory. Lalime would go on to set an NHL record with the longest unbeaten streak to begin a career. In 16 games, he went 14-0-2 before suffering his first defeat in an overtime loss against the Avalanche. Lalime would appear in 39 games in total in that season, with a goals against average of 2.94 and a save percentage of .913, also securing 3 shutouts. He was named to the NHL's all-rookie team, but wouldn't see any NHL action for another 2 seasons after this year. At the end of the 96-97 season, Lalime and the Penguins could not agree on a contract, so he spent the entire season down with Grand Rapids in the IHL. In March of 1998, the Pittsburgh Penguins traded away Lalime's rights to the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim's for Sean Pronger. Lalime failed to make the Mighty Ducks roster after the preseason and was assigned to the Kansas City Blades in the IHL. The following year, the Mighty Ducks would trade Lalime to the Ottawa Senators for Ted Donato and Antti Yussiniemi. He opened the 99-2000 season as a Senator, splitting starting duties with Ron Tugnutt. Lalime performed well and was given the starting duties in 2001-02. In the 02-03 season, Lalime had his best season ever, playing in 67 games with a goals against average of 2.16 and a save percentage of .911, also securing 8 shutouts, leading the Senators to a President's Trophy for having the best regular season record. And he was named an NHL All-Star, and helped the Senators knock off the New York Islanders, the Philadelphia Flyers, before losing to the eventual Stanley Cup champions, the New Jersey Devils, in the Eastern Conference Finals. Lalime would play one more season in Ottawa, where he put up decent numbers, but would never recapture the heights of his 02-03 season again. After the Senators acquired Dominic Hasek as a free agent, Lalime was no longer needed and was traded to the St. Louis Blues. He would sit out the 04-05 lockout season and returned to the NHL in 05-06, playing for St. Louis. He would split time between the AHL and the NHL, but had to sit out most of the season due to injury. St. Louis opted not to re-sign Lalime, and he was a free agent as of July 1, 2006. He was signed by the Chicago Blackhawks for a 1-year contract, likely to back up Nikolai Habibulin. Lalime ended up being injured in training camp and did not debut with the Blackhawks until February of 2007. He would appear in 12 NHL games that season. He would spend part of the 2007-08 season with Chicago, appearing in 32 games. In July of 2008, he was signed by the Buffalo Sabres to a 2-year contract. Lalime would finish out his contract with Buffalo and was renewed for the 2010-11 season, where he only appeared in 7 games, retiring from hockey at the end of the season. After retiring from hockey, he became the French analyst for RDS, until 2014, when he became the primary NHL analyst for TVA Sports. In total, Lalime played in 444 NHL games, with a career goals against average of 2.58 and a save percentage of .905 and 35 career shutouts. He's a one-time NHL All-Star and still holds the record for the longest unbeaten streak to begin a career. Is Lalime Hall of Fame worthy? I don't believe so, personally. He was a good goalie, did really well for the Ottawa Senators, and was a great career backup, but I do not think he is destined for the Hall. But nonetheless, had a solid career. It's all time,